All right, so went through the eyes yesterday and got them started up, you know, for the most part. I think I could always come back and do a little bit of work and do a little touch up, but I'm feeling decent enough along with those that I could just move on to the next thing. So we're gonna start working on the nose. One of the big things about the nose is subtlety and lines. And one of the things that I think that people tend to screw up as far as things like that go, is they start outlining stuff and they start making things a little bit too dark. Less is more, and really what we want to look is for the implied edges of things. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to try to get a little bit of this cheek going on over here, because I know I have a bunch of stuff to do as far as that goes, but I do want to get a little bit of that gray in and on that cheek, and I'll revisit some of that as I go in on the mouth and some of those other areas. But I do want to kind of get that little start of the nose over here, where I'm sort of defining where the cheek and the nostril meet. And that tends to be one of the darker areas. Now, there's a fine line between creating an edge and then outlining. And we want to try to avoid outlining, especially with the nose. It's one of the first things some people do, and it tends to kind of screw things up. So let me just beam down a little closer to that area. I'll focus in my efforts there so you can see all the little things that I'm doing. And we're going to start. Nostril part, the actual black hole there, the nostril, is, you know, one of the easiest things to do, just filling it in black. And 9 times out of 10, students who are like apprehensive about doing the nose, they just make the nostrils black and they feel like they got it. But we have a lot of subtle grays that we have to get in here first, and we just kind of have to find them and put them out there. And making that little part black right in there where the boogers are is really one of the last things that I'm going to worry about right now. I may darken it up just to have a little bit of a reference over there, but the first things first is that I'm going to try to get some of those subtle grays that sort of help define how the nostril sort of gets darker and turns around. I'm going to add just a little bit here, just so I don't lose my spot as I'm working, just so I can kind of see where that is, just because I'm blending a lot in around it. But I'm not going to worry about getting that exactly right this second. What I'm worried about is those light little grays. And I guess the real difference between a good charcoal portrait and now what we're attempting to do for a lot of you is a great charcoal portrait is really finding those subtle little variations of gray. A lot of that is just paying a little bit more attention and literally looking more. And what I mean looking more is like looking at the photograph a little bit more to try to see all those little things that are happening. Every little bit and every little change dramatically can affect how people are going to see the form. Finding all that light and shadow. A little edge here. Just my blending stump on a little bit of that edge. Again, as I blend, when I drag my finger around, just like I told you around the eye, how you kind of like follow the contour, like as if you were touching your own face, doing the same thing over here, except I'm following the contour of the nose. So I want to kind of, again, think of my finger as like I'm just dragging along her face, trying to find the actual real contours that are up in there. And that white bright spot doesn't exist unless we have some gray in there. And that gray is really important because you can't really see the highlights if you don't have at least a little bit of shading in and around it. So it was very light grays. A lot of times the easiest way for me to make that is just use a finger that's a little bit dirty and then just kind of use the charcoal that's already on that finger to make the really, really light gray. Honestly, it's really hard to kind of like develop that lighter touch where you don't go in and just sort of just plop a bunch of charcoal on the paper. So the easiest way to do that is just take a little bit if it's on your finger, especially if you've been working throughout the period, and you know that embedded little bit of gray is just enough sometimes to get just a little bit of value in. All right, next, I've got a little bit more work to do on the nose, but before I go to the mouth and... Okay, lips. Lips are another area that people, I don't know, they always want to outline them, and there is no outline over there. And as we're working, we want to kind of understand that it's just edges, and that that lip starts off just a little bit darker than the skin tone. And you know, that is really where we want to kind of start, by just getting a little bit darker than the skin tone and laying down a little bit of a base color. And you know that what I'm trying to do over here is not create an outline per se, is really just create an edge, a nice clean edge. It's actually not that crisp on this picture for the baby. It's just a subtle change of a ridge where the lip starts curling downwards. What we want is to try to emulate what we see in the picture and not make stuff up. So when people start with that just dark outline for no apparent reason, it really sort of kills the natural looking drawing. You know, it really sort of just takes away from, you know, the beautiful form and everything else like that. So really it's about coming in and trying to be a little bit subtle. I'm going to start with that here. Just using my How was your trip? Right? How was it over there?
Hot.
Is that a trap?
Oh, okay. No.
Like you're touching your own face, yeah. Follow the contours of your actual face. Well, guys, I think it's about that time. Hope you guys are productive over there. I'll check the submitted work and see what else has been put out there. For those of you who've been working away, love to see an update of what you're doing, and especially if you want me to give you my two cents on what to fix and how to fix it. For those of you who are still kind of dragging your feet a little bit, well, there's no time like the present to get started. Let's get going. I will see you all when I see you. I'll see some of you in person tomorrow. And for the rest of you, have a really good day. Stay healthy. Stay happy. And try to get some of this stuff done. All right? And then tomorrow I'll finish everything. All right, guys. Bye.
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 Bye. Bye, y'all.
Thank you.